A very good evening and a warm welcome to His Excellency the Governor's visit to the charity. Let us begin the function with the national anthem. Kindly all rise. Thank you, my friends. Well, dear friends, as you all know, El Shaddai Charitable Trust is a registered non-profit charity working in Goa with the vision of bringing childhood for children who never had one helping, especially the marginalized and across the streets and orphans in Goa. Currently, El Shaddai is running 7 homes, 3 centers, and 3 shelters across Goa, which deserve a huge round of applause. Can we all give a thunderous applause to El Shaddai Charitable Trust? El Shaddai also has won many awards, including the National Award from the Government of India, which deserves once again a huge round of applause. Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji's birthday is being celebrated across the country by Bharatiya Janata Party, BJP. Since Prime Minister Modi ji is completing 20 years of his public life, His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Shri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, announced financial assistance to 71 orphanages and old age homes and supporting dialysis patients from the Governor's Fund to mark the occasion of Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji's 71st birthday. And we are honored as His Excellency has chosen El Shaddai to give his financial assistance. Can we all give a huge round of applause for the wonderful work that we are deserving of? And on that note, my friend, I now welcome His Excellency Governor of Goa, Shri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, with a huge round of applause and a memento given by the children of El Shaddai. Well, dear friends, your thunderous applause must continue. It's a beautiful occasion we are celebrating. Thank you so much. Followed by our dignitaries for the function, I now welcome the MLA of Shiolim, Shri Vinod Palyankar. Can we all give him a huge round of applause? Thank you. The MLA of MAPSA, Shri Joshua D'Souza. Can we all give a huge round of applause? Our Sarpanch of Asagaon, Shrimati Riya Naik. Huge round of applause. Thank you so much. Philanthropist and businessman Sri Sam Kuzikala. Can we all give a huge round of applause? Huge round of applause, my dear friends. And our MLA of Saligaon, Sri Jayesh Salgaonkar. A huge round of applause. Thank you so much. We must also thank Vasu Nair, President of FAGMA, Parental Body of Malayali Association, with a huge round of applause. Ms. Devi Nair, representing Goa Institute of Management, with a huge round of applause. Reverend Shijo M. Abraham of Marthoma Church, can we all give him also a huge round of applause? And Father Varghese from Orthodox Church, with a huge round of applause. Thank you so much, my dear friends. And as they say, without God's blessing, no celebration is complete. And so we are going to do the lighting of the lamp to invoke the blessings of God. To do the honors, let me once again welcome on stage His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, with a huge round of applause, along with our dignitaries, MLA of Shiolim, Sri Vinod Palekar, MLA of Saligaon, Sri Jayesh Salgaonkar, MLA of Mapsa, Sri Joshua D'Souza, co-founder of El Shaddai, Pastor Matthew Kurian, Sarpanch of Asagaon, Srimati Ria Naik, philanthropist and businessman, Sri Sam Kuzikala. With a huge round of applause, my dear friends. I would also love to invite architect Rida Moti to please come and join us. Please come and join us on the stage. Well, dear friends, your thunderous applause should not die. You need to keep clapping. We have such a joyous occasion to celebrate. Thank you so much. And my dear friends, we also have amongst us the additional collector, Mrs. Mom O'Hagan. Can we all give her a huge round of applause? With that note, we also welcome the CWS members, Mrs. Smita Patel and Mrs. Snehal Sangavkar. Can we all give them a huge round of applause? Well, moving ahead with this function, we have two important people who would love to welcome us with their greetings. Let me welcome on stage Reverend Shijo M. Abraham from Mar Thoma Church with a thunderous applause.
Honorable Governor Sridharan Lassa, and all other dignitaries present here. Greetings to you all. I am very happy to stand here and address you in this beautiful evening, because this evening is blessed with a noble cause and blessed with many dignitaries. Here, El Shaddai Trust in Goa doing a wonderful ministry in the name of Jesus Christ. They are helping, they are extending their hand towards the underprivileged, poor and needy people, and also to the children. It's a very appreciable thing. And also our Sridharan Bilasa Governor, Honorable Governor Sridharan Bilasa, he is from Kerala, and we are also from Kerala. He is a very gentleman and very close to all Christian churches in Kerala. He's keeping his good relationship with all the bishops and fathers in Kerala churches. And we are happy that he is extending his hand towards the needy people and also to the El Shaddai Trust. So on behalf of all the Malayali community, Malayali Christian community, and all who present here, I extend our sincere gratitude and appreciation to Sridharan Bilasa for his kind action, for this noble cause. Thank you very much. God bless you. My prayers to you, and my prayers to El Shaddai Trust and the children who are living here. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. And I would love to invite on stage Father Varghese from the Orthodox Church to say a few words. Can we all give him a huge round of applause?
Good evening, all. Respected Honorable Governor of the State and all gatherings, a warm wishes for all of you. His Excellency Honorable Governor of Goa, Sri Sridharan Bilasa, is an intellectual and kind person. We could make out from this charitable work doing by the Raj Bhavan is only because of Excellency. We never heard this kind of charitable work any Rajabhavans in India. We are proud that our Excellency, the Honorable Governor, Sri Sridharan Bilasa, is from Kerala, God's own country. He was very kind towards all the Christian churches in Kerala. So we expect more from His Excellency to the state of Goa. And I congratulate Pastor Matthew Kurian for his works through El Shaddai organization. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, Father Varghese, for those kind words. And now we move ahead with a few words by our MLA from Saligaon, Sri Jayesh Salgaonkar. Can we all give him a huge round of applause?
A very good evening to each and everyone present here. On this occasion, respected His Excellency for the State of Goa, Sri Sridharan Pillaiji, my friends, colleagues in the Assembly, Joshua D'Souza, Vinod Palekar, Father Pastor Kurian, and everybody present here today. This is for the second time I am visiting the Al Shaddai. The first time when I was invited, I had very little knowledge about Al Shaddai and the work they do across Goa and beyond Goa. What excited me to come in this place was Pastor Kurian. I used to see his motivational talks early in the morning on some news channels, on some local channels. And I used to wake up, watch his motivational talks, and then start my day. So when Godfrey Machado, invited me, I said, moreover, it is a visit to meet Pastor Kurian. And even today, when I came here, the first question was, is Pastor Matthew Kurian here? So he said, he's with the governor. We just finished a small meeting with the governor at the governor's palace, His Excellency's palace. We had to submit a memorandum, and from there we had to come here. The cause for today's gathering and the contribution which His Excellency has done today is remarkable and is appreciated across, especially people who have gone through a disease like renal failure, people who have seen their family members or people who have undergone this disease know how important this contribution is. When you say dialysis, when you say a renal failure, a kidney failure, there are only two options. Either you have a transplant of the organ or you keep on doing dialysis. Transplant of the organ happens very rarely, where somebody has to donate you that organ, or a deceased person has to donate that organ to you, or somebody from your family member is willing to donate one kidney because on one kidney you can survive. If that does not happen, the second option is dialysis. And dialysis, a patient can keep on doing dialysis, and the repetition, there are frequent repetitions, and it is once in a month, then it is once in 15 days, then once in a week, then at times alternate days, and at times once in a day. So every day you have to visit a hospital, and it is a very costly affair. My father had to undergo a dialysis, so I know the pain, I know what a patient has to go through. And especially if you are not financially able, then it is more pain. You have to go, you ask for donations, you have to ask for sponsors, meet people, you know. I know what exactly happens when somebody in the family has, and it's the most painful disease. Cancer and dialysis and the renal failure is the most painful disease, and the patient goes on weakening, the health of the patient goes on weakening day by day. So if this kind of contribution is done towards the society, it is specially done in some big people who have big money, you know, if their family member goes to a cancer, then he tends to open a cancer center or cancer something. So he tries to give something back to the society. But that kind of contribution today His Excellency has done, I have never heard His Excellency getting into you know, coming on the field and donating, making such kind of a contribution. So we welcome this gesture, sir, and we hope that Goa will get more from you in coming days. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for those thoughtful words, sir. That was really rightly said. And now we would like to call upon stage the MLA of MAPSA, Sri Joshua D'Souza, to say a few words. Can we all give him a huge round of applause?
A very good evening, His Excellency, Governor of Goa, Sri Sridharan Pilleji, my colleagues, MLA of this constituency, Bab Vinod Palekar, MLA of our neighboring constituency, Saligaon, Bab Jayesh Salgaonkar, respected guests, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, Pastor Matthew. I can't see where he, or there he is. I would like to say a few words about El Shaddai. I have been, my first visit to El Shaddai must have been in the year 2004 or 2005, I think, where the entire society of Kamath Gardens did a small visit to the children that were at El Shaddai during Christmas. And we just came with some sweets and a few presents for them. And the kind of joy and the kind of happiness shown by the children towards us. We sat with them, we sang carols for them. We just had a nice evening with them. I don't think it was more than an hour. But being able to touch children that are taken care of by El Shaddai made me think as a child that there are kids like this who don't have the privileges that the rest of us have. El Shaddai has been working with a lot of people across the society, the poor, the underprivileged, and as we can all see here, most importantly, children. I don't know the amount of effort and the amount of time that Pastor Matthew and his entire team puts in running this entire institution, but I do know that that he is very dedicated, and the entire trust works night and day for the betterment of the children that they have. I would also like to make a special mention with regards to the assistance provided by His Excellency today. Jayesh mentioned that his father also went through dialysis. My aunt, my godmother, as well as my late father also had to undergo dialysis, and we all know the difficulties and the kind of pressures that each family goes under when somebody is going through dialysis. It is a very torturous process. So I would like to wish the institution El Shaddai all the very best in everything that they do. The support extended by my family will continue the way it always has. And I'm sure that having a governor from your home state here as the governor of Goa will also provide extra reinforcement to this institution, and having all the local political bodies along with you will definitely help as well. I would like to wish all of you all the very best, and would like to thank you all for having me as a guest here today. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for those humble and kind words. We now call upon stage the MLA of Sholim, Sri Vinod Palekar, to say a few words, please. Can we all give him a huge round of applause?
Namaskar. Desh ke Pradhan Mantri Mananiya Shri Narendra Modi ji ke जन्मदिन के शुभ अवसर पर आज हमारे राज्य के राज्यपाल साहब महामहिम श्री श्रीधरन पिल्लई जी, इनका मैं मेरे विधानसभा क्षेत्र में तहे दिल से स्वागत करता हूँ। यहाँ उपस्थित मेरे विधानसभा के सहयोगी श्री जय सालगांवकर जी, श्री जोशुआ जी, श्री कुरियन जी और यहाँ उपस्थित सभी गणमान्य अतिथियों का इस अवसर पर मैं तहे दिल से स्वागत करता हूँ। आज का ये अवसर बहुत ही सुवर्णमय अवसर है। ये जो संस्था है, इस संस्था ने जो बुलंदियाँ पाई है, उनके कार्य को मद्देनज़र रखते हुए जो भी उन्होंने कार्य किया है, इस समाज के प्रति न केवल भारत में लेकिन भारत के बाहर भी अगर देखा जाए तो इनका जो कार्य है वो बहुत ही उल्लेखनीय है, सराहनीय है। इसलिए मुझे बहुत गर्व है कि मेरे विधानसभा क्षेत्र में यह संस्था आती है। मैं अक्सर यहाँ आता रहता हूँ, यहाँ जो भी कार्यक्रम होता है और मुझे जब भी बुलाया जाता है, मैं विनम्र से यहाँ आने की कोशिश करता हूँ और उस कार्यक्रम में भाग लेता हूँ। आज भी इस अवसर पर उन्होंने मुझे यहाँ बुला के मुझे मेरा जो मान रखा, इसके लिए मैं शुक्रगुजार हूँ सभी इस संस्था के सभी महनीय व्यक्तियों का। और इस संस्था के प्रति जो भी मुझसे हो जाए वो सब करने की कोशिश मेरी हमेशा रहेगी। इतना बोल के मैं मेरे शब्दों को विराम देता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
एल शदाई चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट की ओर से आपका तहे दिल से धन्यवाद कहना चाहती हूँ सर। एंड डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी ऑल्सो हैव टू गिव मेमेंटोस टू अ फ्यू गेस्ट। वी वुड लव टू प्रेजेंट अ मेमेंटो फॉर रेवरेंड शीजो एम अब्राहम। कैन वी ऑल गिव हिम अ ह्यूज राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज। Thank you. A memento for Father Varghese. Can we all give a huge round of applause? Thank you so much. We would also love to present mementos to the Child Welfare Committee members, Mrs. Smita Patel. Huge round of applause. And to Mrs. Snehal Salgaonkar. Thank you so much. And a memento to the additional collector, Mrs. Mamo Hege. Huge round of applause, my dear friends. Thank you so much. Well, dear friends, the evening has just begun. We have the man himself, the most important man of the evening, who will share a few words with us. Let us welcome with a thunderous applause Pastor Matthew Kurian on the stage. I'm sure he's got lots to say.
I thought she was calling someone else. I never knew that I was so important. Anyway, dear Honorable Governor Sri Sridharan Pillai and my dear friend MLA Vinod Paliyekar, our local MLA, who's always been a support for us, and Jayesh, you spoke so well about me. Thank you so much. Jayesh has been a great guy, and great support. And Joshua, I know Joshua from her childhood. His father was a great supporter of El Shaddai, and he always spoke very well. And when I was going through a real difficult time, he publicly said that El Shaddai is my charity. I will stand with it. And he stood with me. So thank you. I'm very grateful to your family for all the good things they've done. And my friend Sam, Sarpanj Ria, and Father Shijo, Father Varghese, and Secretary to Governor, always been helpful to me. And my friend Architect Rita Modi, Deputy Collector, and my other friend, newly found friend Deputy Collector, and CWC members, and all the friends, families, all of you, thank you so much for coming here this evening. Sir, Sri Governor, I must say that you've been a great example. We never heard any governor coming out of palace saying that I want to visit orphanage and I wanted to give money to orphanage and I want to give money to people who are suffering with their kidney failures. You have set a great example, set a good procedure for all of us to follow. We are very, very grateful. Thank you so much. And the two times I came to your palace and once you met me and Sam together, you spoke so well about us and you have a great heart for Christians and you believe that all religions should coexist together for the better future. And thank you so much. Now, a few things about El Shaddai. El Shaddai started with a slogan of loving, caring, sharing. Love the unlovable, care for the ones whom nobody care, share the goodness of God and man with the people who never experience. These were the words I got in my heart when I started this work. I had no idea this was going to grow into a large charity or I'll become a trustee or whatever, or traveling around. I had absolutely no idea. I happened to go to slums once and I saw the life of Lamanis. And those days, none of the Lamanis were going to school. And they were totally like a real waste, garbage of the society. And I felt bad. I said, they are also fellow Indians and it's not right. We have to do something about it. So I started teaching them family planning, health and hygiene, and how to go to hospital, why your children should go to school. And 28 years we worked, not only us, many others worked. Today, all the children, not only Lemanis, all the children from all the slums go to school. So for me, that's a great achievement. That was the point of starting. And those days, I used to listen to one song says that homeless and the needy will no longer be ignored. All will celebrate favor of God. And when I listened to that song, I said, that's what I want to do. I want everyone to experience favor. The good side of the life should not be for only few people. It should be for everyone. So we've been working for the last 28 years. We have done various things. We got 7 children, so many community centers, shelters for schools. We have a home for men, home for women. And I was talking to my friend Devi Nair from GIMV. She was saying that we must set up a palliative care center. I said, well, let's do it together. So El Shaddai is all about caring for the people who are rejected, neglected, who has nobody to help. And our phone lines are open 24/7. Anybody can call anytime. Any child or any woman or any man who is homeless and don't know what to do, we have a place for all of them. So that's what the El Shaddai is all about. And thank you very much for all of you coming. His Excellency, thank you so much. We are truly, truly grateful. Thank you. God bless you all.
Well, dear friends, a big, big thank you to the co-founder of El Shaddai, Pastor Matthew Kurian. Thank you so much. And as said by our dignitaries, time and over again, His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, has been doing noble work for quite some time. And for the first time in history of Goa, the Governor of Goa is helping with financial assistance and visiting quite a number of charitable institutions, extending his support. He is the first governor to take an initiative of going out and supporting the dialysis patients. He deserves a thunderous applause for doing such great work in our state. And so, my dear friends, I would love to welcome him with a huge round of applause on the stage. And also welcome The El Shaddai's Charitable Trust co-founder, Pastor Matthew Kurian, along with his beautiful wife, Julia Kurian, to please come on the stage. Can we all give them a huge round of applause?
I would request Pastor Matthew Kurian and his wife to please accept this check towards his El Shaddai institution from the Honorable Governor. We have two dialysis patients who are here to receive the financial assistance. Bharati and Agarkekar, please come on stage to please accept the financial assistance. The next one is Srimati Kumud Gaonkar, but she is not able to come. Her daughter, Deepthi, a family member, would be receiving the check. Please come forward. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Can we all give His Excellency the pride? Today here he is present with us. It's such a joyous occasion. The privilege and honor is all ours. His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sridharan Pillai, to say a few words, please. Can we all give a huge round of applause, my dear friends?
Honorable MLAs, Jayashji, Joshuaji, Vinodji, my friend Pastor Matthew Kurian, Sam Kulikala, then Sarpanch, Srimati Riya Naik, so other dignitaries present here, and my dear brothers and sisters, this moment is so auspicious in my life. This fine evening, we gathered here. Of course, as far as the program is concerned, this is not a happy moment as such. But at the same time, the priests are here, Marthoma and Orthodox Sabha in Kerala. Their bishops attended my swearing in ceremony in Goa. So that much relationship with them. And Sam Kulikala is concerned, is just like a brother to me. Of course, these types of program as such is not expected on my side. When I was appointed as the governor of Mizoram, Mizoram people are suffering a lot. I had occasion to visit all the 11 districts within the short time of 3 months. There I found that hilly area, of course, natural beauty is there. But one thing is very clear, the development yet to reach that area. When I go to a district very near to Bangladesh, then I would like to say before you that even a tar road is a strange thing for the people of that district. When I was appointed as the governor in 2019 November, a peculiar situation was existing there. In 2019 January 26, the entire people of Mizoram boycotted the Republic Day celebration officially done by the government. That unfortunate situation even we couldn't experienced in Jammu and Kashmir. Then under such circumstance, that burden of the governor is given to me by the Honorable Prime Minister. Then I on the way to Aizwal, the capital of Mizoram, I met our Honorable Prime Minister. He instructed me, he advised me that don't quarrel with the people, because bitter experience is there, because the state as a whole boycotted a Republic Day is an exceptional thing in our country. Then he directed me, don't quarrel with the people, try to win over them. Then I went there. Within 1 week I found that people are good at heart. So many rare things I had occasion to witness there. Population wise, 88% are believers of Christian community, 9% are Buddhist, 2% are Hindus, and less than 1% Muslims. This is the religious wise fact there. But at the same time, I found that there are peculiarities. If you are going in a vehicle, you need not put your horn. If they realize that we are in a hurry, they will stop their vehicle and allow us to go. Then when you see in the morning, I don't know, in Kerala, in the early morning, the family, female members in the family, they are cleaning their courtyard and other things. In Mizoram, we will be able to see that when that courtyard of the house is cleaning, along with the same highway, public road also, their portion, their cleaning, and no such problem existing there with respect to that road aspect is concerned. These types of so many things were noted by me. Then I thought of how I can have an access to the people. Then of course somebody, I think our Pastor Matthew Kurin, I think so. The governors are, of course, all facilities are available for governor. MLAs, ministers, and they are suffering with always the problems. They are facing the people. Every fifth year, they are expected to approach the people. People are supreme. They will have to give their account before the people. Again in the election, they will get the verdict in favor of them from the people. But as far as governor is concerned, the chief minister is an elected post. As far as a governor is concerned, appointed post. So accountability is of course there, accountability to constitution or Rashtrapatiji, etc., etc., there. But practically, just like a king, you can sit in the Rajbhavan and enjoy life. That is why Pastor Matthew Kurian stated, I would like to add one word. Just like, I don't want to remain there just like a five-star prisoner. All facilities are there. So that is why in Mizoram, first I started to visit all orphanages. I am using the word orphanage. Instead of that, some other proper word is not there. I believe that nobody is born as orphan. God's protective umbrella is there. So I went to all orphanages there. Then one orphanage, myself and my wife went there. Very auspicious moment, happy moment, joyful atmosphere. 21 kids below the age of 15. Even two inmates, there are 6 months, only 6 months age. Then all those students, because the governor is visiting that orphanage, they were very happy. And they marriaged all, everything there, good dress and other things. They welcomed us. Very happy mood. Then my ADC, as an IPS officer from Mizoram, when we reached there, there was they sung a song welcoming us in Miso language. I asked my ADC to interpret it to me. So they were, the small kids and others are singing the song by praying the God to give maximum life for us, happy life for us. Not only for me or my wife, children, grandchildren, everybody. That is the content of that song. Then I found that all these 21 children are HIV patients. That institution was run by, of course, a charitable work done by a 52-year-old Christian lady. She has got double MA. Then I thought, this 6 months-year-old or 1 year-old child, if she is crying, or if he is crying, that boy is crying, and the scratch is there, who will pacify? If a scratch is there, the three ladies there working under the guidance of this main lady, what will the faith? They are praying for life for 100 years or so. But what about their life? All are HIV affected kids. So in such a way, while I prepared a book, for that book one Supreme Court judge, Sirek Joseph, he wrote the foreword. He stated this thing. One chapter is there, I'm a Hindu believer and a 10% Hindu concept of God is my way of worship also. But I wrote in that book, I saw God here in this institution. That is why at a later stage, in 2020, Republic Day, you all know that at that time, Rashtrapatiji declared Padma Awards. I asked my secretary there to contact that lady. Then she very contacted, and through phone I asked her for her whereabouts and her biodata and other things. Then she politely told me, "Sir, I am doing this work for the children. This is a godly work. So I am not refusing your lordship's proposal, but I am thankful to you, but I am not applying for Padma Awards. A governor intended to propose her name for Padma Award, definitely it will have its own weightage there. So this type of dedicated work, in my book, one chapter, I have given the caption heading, I saw the God. So you see, such inspiration, when I was there to visit all orphanages in that place, you see, thereafter, at that time also, my discretionary fund, I am not finding fault with any governors or anybody. Discretionary fund is not subject to MLAs are here, not subject to any auditing. Governor can use in his own way. Of course, very good. So many governors are doing it for the welfare of the society also. But at that time, I never told anybody. I told our Honorable Prime Minister that I have done this. Only person known about this is our Honorable Prime Minister. But when I reached here, again I requested governor is not expected to request. But our secretary wrote to the chief minister, I am not mentioning the amount, MLAs are also here. No publicity is required. Then he allowed that amount also. Then I declared in the name of our Honorable Prime Minister on his 71st birthday, this scheme. So through this process, within 1 or 2 years, if God permits me, I would like to go to every orphanage, and of course with respect to these patients, dialysis patients are concerned. Day before yesterday, when I visited a place, I am not remembering, a hospital, there one thing I noted. Of course, so many Malayali brothers and sisters are also present here. In Kerala, no such scheme is there. Dialysis is free here under the Deenadayal scheme. In our hospitals, it is free. I am under the impression that in Kerala, it is not free. In no hospital, free such things are there. Even in the religious hospital run by religious institutions also, not fully free. Some amount they will have to. So, now I realize that in here the system is there. But even then, for other expenses, this amount given by Rajbhavan may be used. And I have decided to go on with this scheme. Here I am very happy that Pastor Matthew Kurian and his better half also here, they are doing a very good work. When they visited me, of course with respect to the service, a detailed account was given to me. But I am frank, I never expected that this much important work you are doing in this area, and I congratulate you in the name of Rajbhavan for this welfare activities done by for the society here. I have already covered about 11 or 12 institutions, Hindu institutions. Day before yesterday, that place I am not knowing, Ashiana, Muslim or orphanage, they are not Yatim Ghana, they are calling it as Yatim Ghana. There, and Mother Teresa's 2 or 3 institutions I have visited. So I want to do this work. Of course, Rajbhavan governor's discretionary fund is there. We will use that. And I hope if good people are there, so many Malayali people are there in the Gulf as multi-millionaires there. So if I ask them, they will also help us. I am expecting that. Anyway, I want to go on with that. And service to human being is service to God. That is a basic concept of every religion. And I am requesting all of you to cooperate with this movement. And as a governor, I am not going to interfere in any political activities, even though I was very actively in politics. Everybody knows that. And when I was contesting in an election in Chengannur, Sam was working for me there. You are remembering that? But I failed. People didn't give me verdict. Yes, that's true. So I am thankful to all of you, and our priests are also. You are a new Orthodox of us, knew that Baba. So his first, after electing him, his first, that his diocese in Kandanad, he is so particular that I will have to inaugurate that. Then last Sunday, I went there and inaugurated, and on the next day I reached here. And I invited him also to your church, and most probably in March or something he will come. And he agreed to stay one day in our Rajbhavan as state guest. And Marthoma also, Marthoma Sabha is, there are two important bishops, Metropolitan head. When he died, I was the person in that function. I was the chief guest. And Chrysostom Thirumeni also, when he passed away at the age of 103, and promotion was given by Narendra Modi Sarkar, and for his final program of the church also, I was the chief guest there at that time, about 3 months back. So I am very happy that I'm cooperative with all. Our Goa and our India is concerned. The secret behind our success is that Sarva Dharma Samabhav. All religions are Dharma. Their own Dharma is there. But finally we are reaching the same sea, various rivers. Finally they are reaching the river, the sea, that is truth, and all religions are working for that. That is our traditional concept of our Bharat, our India. And I am very happy to see that it is properly, people are cooperating with such a concept, and there was no communal right in Goa, and people are, theory of coexistence is existing in this place, and I appreciate this. And I would like to serve Goa in my own little way, and I am seeking the help. And once more, I am extending my sincere thanks to you. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Well, dear friends, can we all give a standing ovation to His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, for his contributing services to humanity, selfless work. Can we all give him a huge round of applause? Thank you so much, sir. Well, dear friends, they say all good things come to an end, but this is just the beginning of a beautiful evening. We have Miss Malama Natikar, who would love to give the vote of thanks to all of you. Can we all welcome her on the stage, Miss Malama Natikar?
A warm and graceful evening to our most valued honorable chief guest, His Excellency, the Governor of Goa, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, MLA of Saligaon, Sri Jayesh Salgaonkar, MLA of Mapsa, Sri Joshua D'Souza, MLA of Shiolim, Sri Vinod Palekar, co-founder of El Shaddai, Pastor Matthew Kurian, Sarpanch of Asagaon, Srimati Riya Naik, Managing Director of Thunderforce Limited, Goa, Sri Anil Kumar Nair, philanthropist and businessman, Sri Sam Kuzikala, President of FAGMA, Vasu Nair, representative of Goa Institute of Management, Devi Nair, architect and interior designer, Rita Modi, additional collector, Mrs. Mamu Hege, Martomo Church representative, Shijo Abraham, and from Orthodox Church, Father Verghese, CWC members, Smita Patel and Mrs. Snehal Salgaonkar, and everyone gathered here. I consider it a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have made it convenient to attend this function. On behalf of El Shaddai, I extend a really hearty vote of thanks to our chief guest, His Excellency, Sri P.S. Sridharan Pillai, who spared time from his busiest schedule to grace the occasion. Thank you, sir, for taking this initiative to visit our organization. If you wish, you could have spent your time and your money somewhere else for other productive work, but you consider this to be a great opportunity to help more and more children. Thank you, and we are very grateful to you, sir. And today we had an opportunity to hear your thoughts. Service to human being is a service to God, and we will surely going. It will encourage many of us in the future. I take this opportunity to express our sincere thanks to the MLA of Saligaon, Sri Jayesh Salgaonkar, for gracing this occasion. Your presence in this function has immensely enhanced its importance. Thank you, sir, for your kind words and appreciation. El Shaddai will surely keep up with our good work. I would also like to thank MLA of MAPSA, Joshua D'Souza, for supporting us and encouraging us. He has been a good friend of El Shaddai for the couple of years, and thank you, sir. I also express my sincere thanks to all the eminent dignitaries and other esteemed guests for gracing your crucial work and finding this present time. I want to extend my generous thanks to our Dada, co-founder of El Shaddai, Mr. Matthew Kurian, for awakening the passion and desire to support us as a ladder to reach the pole of success. Your constant encouragement has helped us in the best way. Thanks to you, Dada. Lastly, my thanks to our managing director, Mrs. Julia Kurian, and her team, for they have worked with full dedication and motivation to make this program a success. Once again, thank you all for your cordial cooperation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Mallama. Well, dear friends, now we come towards the end of the evening. I would request everyone to please rise for the national anthem. Everyone, for gracing us with the occasion of this lovely evening. Our dignitaries, we request you to please move towards the snacks counter, and also to all my dear friends for your valuable time. Thank you very much. You also can proceed towards the snacks. Please have some snacks, and thank you once again. Have a great, great week ahead. God bless.